Hello, and welcome to Kickin' Cooking in Quarantine. It is 5 o'clock on Monday, so it's me live coming from my kitchen here in Havertown. My name is Mary Bear Shannon. I am a reference librarian at the Haverford Township Free Library, and this is Kickin' Cooking in Quarantine. We have been doing this program since April, weekly coming to you from my kitchen in Havertown. We've been cooking dishes from my recipe box here at from my family to yours, and we're glad to be able to do it. So again, welcome to Kickin' Cooking in Quarantine. Again, my name is Mary Bear Shannon. I am a reference librarian at the Haverford Township Free Library. So we finally got a break in the weather, so that's great. I'm celebrating by actually turning my stove on today. I'm very excited about that. And we will be demonstrating a cake recipe. I'm not sure I've done a cake on this program, so this is a first. I've done a couple of pies, but I'm going to be doing a cake today. Just a couple of program notes to get us started. Kickin' Cooking will be off next week because it's Labor Day, so do not tune in next Monday, because I am actually going to have a day off, like all of the rest of the librarians at the Haverford Township Free Library and all of our staff. And then we are going to a twice a month schedule for Kickin' Cooking in Quarantine. So the second and the fourth Mondays of the month, we'll be doing Kickin' Cooking Quarantine. That is a new program note. So just be aware that we are not gonna be every Monday, but we will be the second and the third Monday of the month doing Kickin' Cooking in Quarantine live from Shay Shannon from my home here in Havertown. A couple of other things. We had our first in-person socially distanced masked event this last week. We did library afternoon in the park at Merwood Park, which was a great success. We had a really nice turnout. Everybody was safe. Everybody was socially distant. We did some story times with our youth services librarian, Riche. And we also did a drumming circle, and it was really a fabulous success. So kind of building on that success, we are actually gonna do another in-person, socially distanced masked event to celebrate women's history and the anniversary of the 100th anniversary of the passing of the 19th Amendment. We actually have a actress and historian who is going to come and interpret the life of Alice Paul. And we are very excited to be partnering with the Haverford Township Historical Society on Saturday, September 19th at 2 p.m. at the Historical Society. So that is on Niter Hall, at Niter Hall on Karakung Drive. Be looking out this week on Facebook and on our website for a registration link. We are going to limit registration because we want to make sure that it is a safe event. Again, it is Saturday, September 19th at 2 p.m. at the Historical Society on Karakung Drive. We're going to ask you to bring a lawn chair and a mask, and we're going to ask everybody to be positioned 6 feet apart while we hear this amazing historian and actress interpret the life of Alice Paul, who is a pivotal figure in the suffrage movement and is local. She's from, her original home is from Mount Laurel, New Jersey. So as I said, be on the lookout for information on Facebook and on our website. So the one last program note I wanted to mention is that this is the 10th year of the library's business breakfast. We have been affording an opportunity for local business people to come and meet and greet and get to know one another. Really, in the last 9 years, we have been at the library, and it has always been such a great community event. Of course, COVID-19 is not allowing us to do that this year, but we are celebrating our 10th year of doing our business breakfast, and we will be doing it virtually. As in years past, we are partnering with the Haverford Partnership for Economic Development, and also be on the lookout for that that invite and that event. That's going to be on Thursday, September 24th. So, kicking, cooking in quarantine. It has been so hot this summer, and I have not wanted to turn my stove off, a stove on. It has been really hard to not turn into a sweaty mess when I was doing this program. And so I really didn't want to cook anything or bake anything. Of course, we had a kind of a break in the weather yesterday. We've had some gorgeous days. That's been a lot cooler. So I ventured today to actually turn my stove on and to actually do a cake. As I mentioned, I don't think I've ever done a cake on Kickin' Cooking in Quarantine. And so we're going to give it a try. I have been looking, rooting through my recipe box that I have in my, that I actually got when I got married. It was a lovely gift, people. I got a box and all of the people who came to my shower actually sent me, gave me recipes. My mom actually sent them recipe cards and they filled them out. So I have all these great family recipes and I've been cooking a lot of them for you. And I was continuing to dig through my recipe box and I came up with this recipe that I think because it's starting, there's a bit of a chill in the air. It seemed like it was time to do first of all, turn on the stove, but also to use apples. So I am going to be doing a down-home apple cake, which just sounds amazing. So I'm really excited about that. And I do love to cook with apples. This time of year, they start to just show up, the fresh apples in the grocery store. I have a CSA and very soon, that's all I'll be getting in my fruit share is apples. At this point, I'm getting all watermelons and melons, but in a couple of weeks, I will start to get apples, and I've been thinking about how to use them all. So this is one of my first attempts this fall to cook with apples. It is one of my favorite things to cook with the fall harvest. So anybody who's watching, let me know in comments, what do you like to cook in the fall that you don't cook any other time? Many of you, I'm sure, like that whole pumpkin spice thing or pumpkin pies. But I'd love to hear what you like to cook when we are looking at the harvest bounty from the fall. Do you like to cook with apples? Do you like to cook with squash? I'd love to hear from you and to see what you are cooking with this fall bounty. Like as I said, today we are going to be cooking with apples. It's this recipe is from my stepdad. He gave me a whole bunch of his recipes when I got married and I had this recipe box and I've been cooking many of them over the years. This one, I actually called him today and asked him if he actually had any stories from this one, and he didn't. He just says, I've had it for a long time. I've cooked it a lot of times. It's a very moist cake, so that's great. And he really liked it, so it looked good. I don't think I've actually ever cooked this. I've eaten it, but I don't think I've ever cooked it from this actual recipe, so I'm excited about that. I think I mentioned earlier this summer that my stepdad was one of the first men in my life to actually know how to cook. My dad did not know how to cook. He knew how to grill. When my mom got remarried and I met this man, he was cooking all the time and cooking things in big batches and freezing them. So he did not have to cook every night. He is a very good cook. And I just remember that having a huge impact on me to actually meet a man that knew how to cook. Again, I grew up in a time where men didn't cook unless they had to. And of course my dad had to learn eventually because he and my parents split up. And so he did learn how to cook, but growing up, he did not know how to cook at all. That was one of my memories was meeting him and watching him cook and him sharing his recipes with us. So Anyway, the down-home apple cake, it's very moist, and I'm getting really excited to show you how to do it. So, let's go over to my kitchen and we'll show you how to do the down-home apple cake. So here we go. Okay. So again, we're in my kitchen. I'm gonna tilt this down. Of course, you're not gonna see my face. You're gonna see my midsection, but that's okay. And we're gonna get started on this recipe. It is gonna start with something that you may not usually see in more current recipes, but it calls for this, and I think you know, there is a place for this ingredient. I think a lot of people got a little leery about using this, thinking it was too fatty, but I think in certain circumstances, this is the perfect ingredient, and that is shortening. A lot of people are like, oh, shortening, you know, that's what my grandmother used, or what that's what my mother used. But this calls for 2/3 of a cup of shortening. Now, this again is one of my favorite gadgets in the kitchen. It's one of the, this is called a Knorr Pro. I've had one from Pampered Chef called the Wonder Cup. And when you put really squishy, like peanut buttery and things, this is a great rest. This is a great gadget because it actually measures the amounts here all the way down to 2 cups. And then when I'm ready to put it in, I just push from the bottom and it comes out, and it easily comes off of that. So it's just one of those gadgets that I'm not sure I would know what to do without. And that would be interesting to hear what are the gadgets in your kitchen that you really can't do without. That's one of them for me. So this recipe starts with creaming the shortening with 3 cups of sugar. I actually had to call my stepdad and ask him, is it really 3 cups? Because it looked like it had been changed on the recipe. He said, actually, in fact, it is 3 cups of sugar that you cream with the shortening. So we'll get started that. You know, I think if I had a standing mixer, which I don't have, I just can't afford that at this point, I might do this with a mixer, but I'm just creaming. This is what how I was taught how to cream a kind of a fat with a sugar, and we're just using the back of our spoon, and we are mixing up and creaming the shortening with our sugar. So we're gonna get this incorporated with the 3 cups of sugar. Shouldn't take too long. So you're gonna basically do the kind of wet ingredients and the, you know, the more oily ingredients, and then we're going to put in our dry ingredients. So we're getting there in terms of creaming the sugar into shortening. I'd love to also hear, is there anybody else that use shortening in your cooking? I know, again, it is one of those older things. You don't see it as often in recipes, but again, I think it has its place. Some of you may have remembered me making scones. The Alton Brown recipe actually calls for butter and for shortening, and he swears by it. He says, you know, you just can't make they just not as good without the shortening. And I would have to agree. That is one of my favorite recipes, and I really think that without the shortening, it would not be as good. So we are pretty much creamed at this point, the shortening into the sugar. The next kind of wet ingredient is 2 cups or 2 eggs. I just have this lightly beaten, and we're going to put that in. And then here's the surprise ingredient. It's going to call for 1 cup, and I realized I did not have this out, not always planned, a cup of coffee. Ooh. And this is just, I just made this a little while ago. It's not piping hot anymore, but it may, and we want to make sure that it is, I just don't want to cook my egg. So we'll kind of put this in little by little. It's not piping hot, but again, I don't want scrambled eggs. And I should have made this a while ago, but I was rushing back from the library. So I don't want to put in this all at once and cook my eggs. It's just warm, but it's, again, I don't want to cook it. So we'll just put this in a little bit at a time and stir this in. So these are going to be all of our wet ingredients. I think the coffee is kind of an interesting aspect to this this recipe. I asked my stepdad why coffee. He says it just adds kind of to the richness as well as the color of this cake. Although we're going to have some seasoning in it, and that's going to help with the color as well. So again, we're just putting about a cup in, and I think I'm pretty close to having a cup. I think I poured too much in there, but anyway, we'll just put a little bit more in here, and that's about a cup. Okay. So again, I have my shortening, I have my sugar, I have my eggs, and I have this one cup of coffee. Okay, so those are my wet ingredients. Now I'm going to add the dry, and it starts with 3 cups of flour, just regular all-purpose flour, and we're going to start to build this batter. The other things we're going to put in here are spices. But here's the leavening agent. This is the baking soda. I'm gonna kind of spread that around. 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. So again, this is gonna be nice and spicy. And 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. One of my favorites. And again, these are really the flavors of fall. You know, cinnamon, nutmeg. This is a half a teaspoon of cloves, which again gives you that nice kind of spiciness. And then lastly, 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Pretty much everything you bake should have some salt in it. So okay, so we are going to stir this up and incorporate all of these dry ingredients in with our wet. And so again, it kind of has that nice kind of light brownness to it, with the coffee as well as the spices. It smells divine. So anyway, that's the basis to the batter. Now, the 2 things we're going to put in are 1 cup of raisins. So that's just 1 cup of raisins. And then we're going to, I just did this before I came on camera. This is grated apple. And I did it in the food processor. I know that, you know, back in the day when my stepdad made this, he probably used a box grater. I was not interested in grating my knuckles today, so I decided that I was going to actually do this in the food presser. So we need about 2 cups, and I think this looks about that much. So I am going to put that in, and that's really going to give a lot of the moistness to this cake is the apples. And I did it right before I went on camera because I didn't want it to turn brown. So we're going to put the grated apple, the raisins in with this batter, which is flour and sugar, and we have nutmeg and cinnamon, as well as a little bit of cloves. I mean, some people don't particularly like cloves, but I think this goes really well with these other spices, a little bit of salt, eggs, and then the shortening. Again, it is one of those things where some people are like, oh, shortening, that's from way long ago, but I think that it works in this recipe. Okay, so this is pretty much incorporated now. So this is going to go in either a tube pan or a bundt pan. Now, I do not have a tube pan, so I prepared a bundt. Of course, I love that movie, the my big fat Greek wedding, where the Anglo mom comes to the big Greek party and says, I brought a bunch. And they didn't know what she was saying. So finally they said, oh, it's a cake. So a bunch pan for our cake. Okay, so we're gonna put this in around the two, around the center. Again, this is really got a nice fluted edge. It's gonna be really pretty when it comes out. The other thing is I greased this and I floured it so it's more easily extracted at the end when it comes out of the oven. Okay, so we're gonna get all that goodness into our bunch pan. And I'm gonna actually take my spatula, or spatula, depending on where you're from, and get all the rest of this goodness into the pan. Now, once this is ready to go, it is gonna go in an oven for an hour at 350. I've got something in the oven at the moment, so I am gonna wait until that is out to put this in again. It looks fairly raw at this point, but it should come out really beautifully. And again, I greased and I floured this pan, so it should come out really well at the end. So anyway, that is my down-home apple cake. When I am done, I will post the final product and the verdict from my family. It should be good. I think they all love the apples and the spices in cakes. And again, it's supposed to be a very moist cake. So that's it. I'm going to leave this here ready to be put in the oven. So that is our down home apple cake. I see that Mary Jones said, I have my aunt's apple crisp recipe, which is absolutely excellent as long as you aren't counting calories. Yes. So same thing with this. I think with the shortening, you have to just, it's that whole, you only live once. I love the whole combination of apples and cinnamon and nutmeg and cloves. So anyway, that's it for Kickin' Cooking in Quarantine. We made a down-home apple cake. I will post the final product and the recipe onto this Facebook Live event after it comes out of the oven. So I'm really glad that you joined me today, and I hope you have a great week.